So we're at NAB 2011. We actually have a live tattoo parlor in our booth. We're looking for good ways to figure out how to show the quality and the resolution of the cameras. And one of our team said, how about a real tattoo parlor? We all said, great idea. Make it happen. And here it is. So this is a Scarlet. This is sort of as entry level as we get from a product standpoint. This is like the junior brother of an Epic, right? So an Epic is, of course, 5K resolution. It's working on some of the biggest movies in the world right now. This camera will be coming out in a few months. It's got a 3K sensor in it. It's a completely professional piece of gear. It will compare or exceed in quality to pretty much every other piece of gear in the market that claims they are digital cinema cameras. They're essentially just TV level cameras. This camera has a 3K Bayer pattern sensor in it, a very advanced lens that actually controls focus, iris, and zoom off one ring, and it's assignable. And this is, you know, a professional usable, so you can do feather focus and feather zoom. It's a built-in fixed lens. It's designed as a true hybrid camera, so it shoots motion and still at the same resolution, as opposed to the DSLRs, which of course shoot incredible stills, but very low resolution motion. And they're not really designed for it. You can only run them for X amount of minutes at a time, then they overheat, you gotta turn them off, all that. This is obviously just designed to do its job, which is shoot motion and stills. It does all the same things that a Red One and an Epic do in terms of shooting the red code raw and then moving that through the logical, easy post-production workflow, which of course is incredibly well industry supported. Everybody does it in real time with our Red Rocket card. So Avid and Final Cut and all the DI stuff is all real-time prep for ProRes or DNX through the card, and then real-time DI through essentially anything you want. So all the same rules apply here. It's been happening on all those big movies shot with the Red One and an Epic. You control the camera wirelessly via this thing called a Redmote, which can come on and off the camera. We actually have a new iPad application that does the same thing as a Redmote, and you can actually control the camera from an iPad, set color combinations for the looks that you want. The monitor's all touchscreen, so you know we can alter the ISO, we can set focus. It also has autofocus capabilities, so the lens is autofocus, just like an SLR. You tap it to get focus. You can change the formats. You can shoot slow motion up to 120 frame in the full 3K, and then you can go even higher if you take it down to 2K. You have the ability to change your red code, compression, the frame rate. You can shoot slow motion just by, you know, zoom dialing it up, and then you go into a very speed mode. We can take it all the way up to 120 frame a second without an issue. You know, all that stuff is just sort of how the camera works. It's very intuitive. There's four channels of audio right in the camera, so I can, you know, enable the audio menu or turn it off. You're shooting raw, so you have a tremendous amount of latitude on the camera. And that's it, other than my froggy voice from 3 days at NAB. There's lots more to it, but that gives you kind of a general idea of what it does.
I heard something about Wi-Fi capability.
We have something called RedLink, which is actually our sort of secure version of a wireless link to the camera. That's how we control the iPad and the Redmote. I could take this off, put that on a crane 100 feet in the air, and control the camera that way.
For those who may not know, can you give us like a sensor comparison maybe to what's out there?
Sure. So the Red One and the Epic, there is no comparison on the motion side. On the still side, obviously Canon and Nikon make very high resolution still sensors. When they turn them into video cameras, you get a little over 1K of resolution, just to give you an idea of what you're actually shooting with this. So it's a little less than 720p, actually, in its true resolution, even though it's packed into a 1080p holder. Essentially, every camera packs less resolution into their holder, including Red. So when you have a Red One camera, it's a 4K sensor bucket, and we derive a 3.2K image from it, which is actually, when you measure it, about the same resolution as 35mm film, which is why when you go see a movie like The Social Network or Book of Eli or any of these other big movies that have come out shot on the Red, the new Pirates of the Caribbean that'll be out in the summer, this summer, it looks like it's shot on a high resolution professional movie tool, because it is. Everything else on the market to date is 2K on down in terms of how it resolves an image. So they're basically TV level cameras. Doesn't mean they're bad cameras, it just means they're not legitimate movie cameras for the big screen. So the images look relatively soft. then you have to artificially sharpen them if you want to try and make them look okay on the big screen. That's where you get all that contrast and sort of stuff that's not really palatable to look at, because the red is all resolution with no sharpening, right? Similar to film. The Epic is a 5K sensor, which derives a true 4K image. That's why we go to an even bigger sensor on the camera that's right here. That's 5K Bayer pattern sensor drives true 4K res, right? So that is actually now exceeding the measured resolution of scanned film at 4K. I know there are other companies finally starting to pay attention to this. Nothing's out yet on the market, but we're actually looking forward to some valid competition in the marketplace. And you know, we're obviously way far ahead. This camera compares to the same quality of those other cameras that would have the larger sensors in them and derive a 2K or 1080 image. That's about the resolution you get out of this camera, except this camera is going to be much more affordable, and you're shooting true raw, and you're shooting completely on board, right? So you're shooting to this SSD module, so you don't have to have any external recording devices. And you're looking probably somewhere between $6,000 for a package like this, maybe a little more, a little less. We haven't determined the final pricing yet. Late summer to fall is probably a pretty good target for when we're going to ship these, yeah.